Bandwagon Fallacy, also known as ad populum. The bandwagon fallacy is an argument that appeals to the fact that a group of people, or all people, hold an opinion. Therefore, that opinion must be right. Pretty much this argument, which doesn't make sense, which is why it's a fallacy, goes like this. Everybody else thinks so, so this is right. Here's an example. I know it, they know it, everyone knows it. Therefore, I will be the best school president. This is an example of that type of fallacious argument, the bandwagon fallacy. Because how will we know he's going to be the best school president just because everyone else thinks so? Now, it can also be set up where the conclusion comes first and the premise comes second. So like this, I will be the best school president because I know it, they know it, everyone knows it. Example number two, everyone who knows anything knows that Team USA soccer is the best. Therefore, USA soccer is the best team in the world. Again, this is an example of the fallacy. Just because everyone else is saying it, or in this case, everyone who knows anything, so smart people, doesn't mean that Team USA soccer is the best. You have to have evidence. What evidence do you have? Do you have game records? Do you have stats on the team? That would seem to indicate whether they're the best or not. But just because everyone who knows anything saying that, or somebody's claiming that everyone says that, doesn't make the argument valid. How do we identify an ad populum fallacy? So number one, we determine the premise and the conclusion. Then we ask, is the premise stating that everyone thinks or knows something? Then we ask, is the conclusion stating that whatever they think or know is right or true? If this is the case, then it's a bandwagon fallacy, also known as ad populum. Why? Because the argument is totally based on the fact that people think something or everyone thinks something, therefore it's right or true. It has no evidence. It's just making a claim about everyone. And we can't possibly know what everyone thinks or believes. Example number three, 75% of voters chose Jameson for president of the United States. Therefore, Jameson will make a good president. Again, just because a group of people, even a large number, choose somebody to do something, doesn't mean that person will be good or honest, because you don't know what the background of the people are. However, you can say that he's popular, and actually ad populum, populum means people. We get the word popular from that word. But you can't make the claim that he'll be a good president. Good? You now have to look at his character, not just what people think or how many chose him. Example number four. Everyone in my family thinks that being a doctor is the best job in the world. Therefore, being a doctor is the best job in the world. Again, who is your family and what evidence do they have? Is it just because they're saying it? There's no evidence to show that the doctor is being the best job in the world. Again, is there any evidence for what they say, or are you just using the fact that they said it? Who is your family to make that type of judgment? You need evidence to show that being a doctor is the best job in the world. And if there is no evidence except everyone in my family thinks so, you don't have an argument, and your conclusion is not supported. Trivia. Ad populum is a Latin term which means to the people. Because the argument uses the fact that a lot of people think or believe something as its evidence that we should think or believe the same things. And again, that's fallacious reasoning. It's not valid. There's no evidence there. Because just because everyone thinks or believes something doesn't mean that we should think or believe it too. It doesn't mean it's true or right. There has to be evidence to show that it's true or right. Now the term bandwagon, the other name for this fallacy, where does it come from? Well, it refers to political campaigns in the past. We're talking about 17 and 1800s. In the past, politicians would go through cities riding on a bandwagon. There would be musicians with them. And as they were campaigning and telling people what they would do for them and why they should vote for them, they would tell them to get onto the bandwagon in order to show their support and agreement. So it would make a kind of show. So now they would say, "See, everyone is following me. Everyone's gonna vote for me. You should vote for me too." So it was really appealing to all the people. Look at this. Everyone's voting for me. You should too. So it's the same idea for the fallacy. And now this new term refers to the fallacy as opposed to ad populum. But they both refer to the same thing. Example number five. You should not feel guilty that you did not help out your sister. No one else helped her out either. Again, now you can sense where the problem is in this fallacy. Especially when it comes to family. You didn't help her. No one else helped her either. You're still feeling guilty. because you know it was the right thing to help out your sister, even though nobody else did. So we don't follow the people as our guides. We follow our conscience, we follow evidence, and we follow facts to support our conclusions. Thanks for watching. Until next time.